Children, it is a continuation of the chapter acids, bases and salts. Now let us continue the chemical properties of acids and bases. Now about the reaction of metallic oxides with acids. Reactions of metallic oxides with acids. So children, you know that metallic oxides are basic in nature. How does metallic oxide react with acid? Children, you do one activity. Take a small amount of copper oxide. Small amount of copper oxide, that is black in color. Take a small amount of copper oxide in a beaker and add dilute hydrochloric acid slowly while stirring. Here you add dilute hydrochloric acid HCl slowly while stirring. Note the color of the solution. What has happened to the copper oxide? Here what happens? The color of the solution becomes blue green and the copper oxide dissolves. What is the color of the solution? Color of the solution is blue green. What is that blue green? That is copper cupric chloride. Copper chloride, CuCl2. Copper oxide, which was black in color, dissolves in dilute HCl, gives copper chloride, that is blue green, gives what? Copper chloride, together with, that is water, CuCl2 plus water. So this is the reaction between the metallic oxide and acids. So here HCl is acid, CuO is the metallic oxide, that is a copper oxide. So what is the reason for the blue green color of the solution? That is due to the formation of the copper chloride, CuCl2. Here the valency of the copper is 2. So you can take here that is copper, valency is 2, copper chloride. Copper chloride together with water. So here when the copper oxide is black in color, it is black in color and it changes to blue green. That blue green is the copper chloride. CuCl2 is salt. CuCl2 is salt. Metal oxide react with acid. Metal oxide react with acid to give salt and water, which is similar to the neutralization. That is reaction of a base with an acid. Hence metal oxide are base in nature. As the metal oxide gives salt and water with the acid, you can consider that these metal oxides are basic in nature. So in general, you can summarize. In general, you can write metal oxide plus acid give salt and water. It is also neutralization reaction. Hence the metal oxide acts as a base. It is basic in nature. So let us write that metallic oxide also they are basic oxide react with acid to form salt and water. So you can give here generally you can write that metal oxide plus acid gives salt and water. Salt and water. So you can give examples. First one you give copper oxide. Copper oxide, which is black in color, dissolves in dilute HCl. Dilute HCl. Here copper oxide is CO and HCl is dilute hydrochloric acid. You take dilute hydrochloric acid. Dilute hydrochloric acid gives copper chloride. Copper chloride. Copper chloride is blue green in color. Blue green in color. So let us write that reaction. CuO, that is copper oxide, plus HCl. You must know this. This is copper oxide, which is black in color. CuO is copper oxide, which is black in color, and HCl is hydrochloric acid. Here you have taken dilute hydrochloric acid. React with each other means copper oxide dissolves in hydrochloric acid to give CuCl2. So you take, that is CuCl2. CuCl2 is copper chloride. Then you take H2O. So it is copper oxide, which is black in color. Black color. This is dilute hydrochloric acid. Dilute hydrochloric acid gives copper chloride plus water. This copper chloride is blue green. It is one example. Second example, let us take one more example of metal oxide, sodium oxide. So you take sodium oxide dissolves in dilute acid, or you take generally acid, or particularly dilute hydrochloric acid. Dilute hydrochloric acid to give salt and water. To give salt and water. Then what is the molecular formula of sodium oxide? You take Na2O plus HCl gives NaCl plus H2O. If you want to balance, you balance it. Here Na is there, so Na2 is there, so you take NaCl, that is 2NaCl, and here H2 is there, then you take 2HCl. Here also, if you want to balance, you can balance. CuCl2 becomes here 2HCl, 2Cl and H2O 2H. So here you balance, you must put 2. Here also you take 2 here and also 2 here. So you got a balanced chemical equation of the reaction between the sodium oxide and hydrochloric acid. Here what is it? Sodium oxide, you take it is sodium oxide. This one you know, no need of writing again. Then this is what? This is sodium chloride, NaCl, cooking salt. Sodium chloride. This one you know, that is water. Then one more example you take, magnesium oxide. So you write magnesium oxide react with or dissolves in dilute hydrochloric acid. Dilute hydrochloric acid to give again salt and water. Salt and water. Here, what is the molecular formula of magnesium oxide? That is MgO. MgO plus hydrochloric acid HCl gives MgCl2 plus H2O. MgCl2 plus H2O. You take magnesium oxide, this is magnesium oxide, this is here magnesium chloride, that is salt. This is magnesium chloride. Then why are metal oxides basic in nature? So you take, why are metal oxides basic in nature? Did you know metal oxides react with acid to give salt and water, which is similar to neutralization, that is the reaction of base with an acid. Hence metal oxides are basic in nature. So you write answer here, metal oxides react with acid to give salt and water, which is similar to neutralization. That is reaction of base with an acid. Hence, metal oxides are basic in nature. Metal oxides are basic in nature because metal oxide react with acid to give what? Salt and water. This is similar to neutralization, that is a reaction between the base and acid. You know that when base reacts with acid to give salt and water, gives salt and water. So the metal oxide also gives salt and water with the acid. So you can say that metal oxides are basic in nature. Then let us take the non-metallic oxides, reaction of non-metallic oxide with base, reaction of a non-metallic oxide with base. So you take reaction of non-metallic oxide, non-metallic oxide with base, non-metallic oxide with base. Earlier we discussed about the reaction of metallic oxide with acid. What we have discussed, reaction of metallic oxides with acids. Here the reaction of non-metallic oxide with acid. You know what are non-metal and what are metal. And metals are, the examples you can give, copper, aluminium, iron, cobalt, nickel, sodium, etc. Non-metals, you know, carbon, silicon, hydrogen, all these are non-metals. And when non-metal oxides, here we observed the reaction between the carbon dioxide and calcium hydroxide. You know that calcium hydroxide is a base, CaOH twice, it is a base. And that carbon dioxide passes through the calcium hydroxide, which is a lime water, that is basic in nature, and produce salt and water, that is calcium carbonate. Since this is similar reaction between the base and an acid. So again here you can clear that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. So you take one example here, that is the reaction between the carbon dioxide and calcium hydroxide. Carbon dioxide is a non-metallic oxide and calcium hydroxide is the basic solution here you have taken. So you take, so let us take non-metallic oxide, non-metallic oxide reacts with base to give salt and water. Salt and water, and it is also neutralization reaction. So let us, here you write, what is that? Non-metallic oxide plus base gives salt and water. Salt and water, it is also neutralization reaction. Therefore, as here there is base, you can consider this is an acid. In the previous example, we have taken, what is that? Metal oxide reacts with acid, gives salt and water. So here we have considered this is base. Why? Here we have taken acid. Here HCl, H2SO4, you can take here. Here we have taken HCl, that is an acid. So metal oxide reacts with acid to give salt and water. Salt and water, here you write plus. Then as it is an acid, you can conclude it is a base. So metal oxides are basic in nature and this non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature because it reacts with base to give salt and water. That is the generalization here. So non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature, metallic oxides are basic in nature. So you can give the example here. Example, you take carbon dioxide reacts with carbon dioxide reacts with calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide, which is base, to form salt and water, that is to form calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate and water. Here calcium carbonate is salt. So you take CO2 that we have discussed in the reaction between the carbon dioxide and lime water. When carbon dioxide is passed through the lime water is nothing but calcium hydroxide. The lime water turns milky. White precipitate of calcium carbonate is formed. So you can take CaOH twice. That is calcium hydroxide, which is also called as lime water. That gives CaCO3. CaCO3 plus H2O. Here this is carbon dioxide. This is calcium hydroxide. That is a base. And calcium carbonate, that is the salt here, and it is H2O. So let us take the question. Let us answer the question. How does non-metallic oxide become acidic in nature? So take that. How does non-metallic oxide become acidic in nature? Non-metallic oxide. So here you take non-metallic oxide react with base to give salt and water. Salt and water, which is similar to neutralization, hence it acts as an acid. So you take here CO2 plus CaOH twice. That is the example you take here. CaOH twice gives CaCO3 plus H2O. Here this is a non-metallic oxide, carbon dioxide, because carbon is non-metal. Then calcium hydroxide, it is a base and gives CaCO3, calcium carbonate, which is a salt. So here, as it is base, as you got salt and water, it must be basic in nature. So you can